Sankofa, high in the heavens you soar. My soul is soon to follow you back to yesterday's moon. Will it remember me back to yesterday's sun? It will rekindle me, rekindle the spirit into tomorrow and high on the wind. Sankofa flies again and again.
Joyce Cobb was born on June 2, 1945 in Okmulgee, Oklahoma, and sang her first song when she was 3 at her grandmother's church. I sang my first song when I was 4 in church. I need just a little more Jesus. Hey, I need just a little more Jesus. Miss Cobb says, after she first sang, she was addicted to the applause and the acceptance. This is what motivated her to keep singing. My sisters and I would sing all the time around the house. My parents would always get tired of us. In 1955, her family moved to Nashville, Tennessee, where her father was hired at Tennessee State University as the head of the Health and Physical Education Department. Her parents owned a large record collection of music that was influential on her at a young age. She went to school that supported the arts during grade school and high school. She sang in the girls' glee club and choir at that time. I sang at Stax Music Academy and with the Memphis Black Arts Alliance. Cobbs also had 4 years of private piano training. Ooh, I'm taking piano lessons right now too. From 1963 to 1967, she attended Central State University and acquired an undergraduate degree in social welfare. She hated that she didn't decide to major in music. Her professional music career started in Dayton, Ohio, singing with different blues and jazz bands. While pursuing a master's degree at Wright State University in social work by day, she was singing in clubs at night. She was not happy with her social work job. She wanted to pursue music full time. One day, as Cobb was in the elevator, she met Bill Timmy. She was offered a road gig singing in duo with Bill Timmy for Ramada Inn Hotels. And she said goodbye to being a social worker to become a professional singer and songwriter. This should teach all of you performers out there to always be prepared for anything. Between 1969 and 1971, Cobb was on the Ramada Inn's Midwest Circuit for Entertainment, performing in duo under the title Joyce and William, both singing and playing guitars. After 2.5 years of working for the Ramada Hotel chain, she returned to Nashville in 1971 and worked in a variety of musical genres, appearing at the Opryland, on radio, and on television. She was one of the first acts in Opryland, USA in 1972 and was voted Best Performer in 1974. During that time, she had cut her first single for the Truth record label and was first nationally recognized in the May 1975 edition of Billboard with her single, He Just Loved You Out of Me. This first country music single was to launch her career. It was the last time she would record any country music. Due to her early success in country music with a promising hit single, in 1976, she was signed with Stax Records and put under a contract. Unfortunately, the label was in decline at this time. Cobb would in fact be the last artist signed to Stax, as the label went out of business shortly after she moved to Memphis. She stayed in the city due to the difference in diversity in music. Everything was black, black music, black bands. She said, oh, I wanna stay here. In the late 1990s, she forwarded the concept of Sounds of Memphis to help write the script for the show Beale Street Saturday Night, which it had a success as the live show in the mid part of the country. This was her first inroad to what had been an acting career later in her professional life. In 2006, she recorded on the soundtrack of Black Diamonds, the story of Negro League Baseball, as part of the internationally recognized exhibit presented at the Memphis Pink Palace Museum. In the last 16 years, Cobbs has been the lead actress and singer for numerous award-winning live productions to include Amos Behavin, Lady Day at the Emerson Bar and Grill, and The Life and Times of Bessie Smith. In 2010, she toured Europe with Michael Jeffrey Stevens Trio, promoting the CD release for Archer Records. Presently, she continues to perform every Sunday in Memphis, Tennessee, at Bosco's, as well as playing many other engagements internationally.
Sankofa, high in the heavens you soar. My soul is soon to follow you back to yesterday's moon. Will it remember me back to yesterday's sun?
Hi, my name is ShaKya, Avant, and it's my greatest pleasure to introduce Miss Joyce Cobb.
ShaKya?
Yes, ma'am.
What a great name. You've got to live up to that name now.
What skills have you learned that will help you, that have helped you in your singing career?
Well, I think that studio, recording studio, was the best training ground. To be able to relate a feeling, to relate a lyric with emotion on audio, to me is the best training.
What advice would you give anyone just starting in the music business?
It's a good training to learn an instrument or learn the basics of an instrument and learn it through theory. I always thought that vocalists should be trained the way they train saxophone players and clarinet players and violin players, and that is learn to read, sight read. You know, I really think the hardest part of this business in the arts, to be honest, is not really the exceptional talent that you have, but it's finding those human connections that can make a difference in your career. There are people that you can call in 3 minutes and they can make a deal for you overnight. Because performance is really based on a lot of hit and runs, acceptance and rejections. What you want is stable income. So it's, since you're in music and performance and theater, also learn the business of it.
Thank you, Ms. Cobb, for your time, talent, and spirit, and for being a true staple in our Memphis heritage.